student, I'm Mr. Liang. Because I'm going to make different debriefing videos for the DSE or HKC EEMC questions, so that's why I would like to grab this chance to tell you how should be our mindset when doing exercise, when doing the past paper. So for the first idea is that by doing past paper, exercise, no matter in the textbook or what, so actually the concept is the assessment of learning.So that's a way to check that how well you learn the biological concepts and some scientific investigation skills. So that's why in every question, we must be able to find the shadows of the biological concepts and the skills. And there are three types of concepts. They can be checked in the questions. So the level one concept is the very straightforward one.So the question may just ask you to name the structures, to identify the functions, or even check the definition of the particular scientific concepts, osmosis, diffusion, something like this. So of course, not only this type of question. For example, if the question asks you to tell the positive result of the food test or the DCPIP test, it's also a very straightforward question.And for the level 2 concept is reversed thinking. As I mentioned in the lesson, it's always called the disease approach. So that's why we do not directly ask you the function of a particular organs. So what I ask is that what will happen if the particular organs cannot function normally? So that's why in different topics, digestive system,body defense and also the plant structures. You can still recall the concept of ringing experiment. So we know that we remove the phloem vessels in the bark. So that's why what will happen for the plants, for the trees, after we remove the bark. What will happen if we remove the phloem vessels in the ringing experiment? And for the level 3 concept is about the daily life practice. So that means you need to apply the biological knowledge in our daily life. So for example, we are going to talk about which type of food should we eat in order to prevent a particular type of deficiency disease. So of course, for this question, it will not onlyask you about the deficiency disease, but also they may relate it to the food test and then put all of them together to make sure that you really apply what you learn. So that's why firstly, you may need to identify the deficiency disease based on the given sign or symptoms, and then you need to identify which types of food substance do the patients not intake sufficiently. For example, the vitamin C, for example, calcium, something like this, and thenAccording to the result of the food test. So for example, in front of us, there are food samples A, B, C, D, and then we find out that the food sample B, it contains a lot of vitamin C. We, based on the first and second step, we know that, oh, because the patients, he or she, they have the breathing gums or thehealing of the wound is very, very slow. So that's why we can determine that thispatient should suffer from scurvy. And then, oh, for food substance B, because it contains a lot of vitamin C, so that's why I suggest food substance B for the patients to eat more in order to cure or to prevent the deficiency disease scurvy. That's the first logic I would like to tell. And the second logic is that by doing past paper or exercise actually is a way for you to learnSo that's the assessment as learning. So that's a tool for you to learn. So my belief is that you practice and you really monitor your own progress based on the feedback. No matter you get it wrong or get it correct, you can learn from your experience. So that's why when doing the exercise, I suggest the students to making some notes or stick a memo paper on the questions, no matter you get itwrong or correct. So that's an easy way for you to check the concept later on. So that's why when you do the question, stay calm and take it easy. Of course, you need to take it seriously, but don't take it too seriously. And then, oh yeah, I get it wrong, and then it will be the end of the world. Not really. If you get it wrong, so that's a way for you to learn from this question. Why I misunderstood this concept?And if you get it correct, so congratulations, you learned that concept well. So check how well you learned. Don't Don't only focus on how many questions you got correct, but also how can you get them correct. As I always mention in the class, so try to do revision together, because you do not only fight alone. You do the questions and then you can try to explain it to others when you get it correct but others get it wrong. So that's also a way for you to learn. Enjoy!